The corn laws protected the farmer from the impact of cheap foreign corn. So below 80 shillings a quarter, restrictions would not be withdrawn. The Anti-Corn Law League was formed to achieve support for its central purpose, to cheapen food for God's people and thereby diminish the fear of widespread agitation. More money around, men trade should be bound to profit from the surplus, while markets more free would make better the feeling between the industrial nations. And so Peel began to feel the need for repeal was real. That the need for repeal was real was how Peel began to feel. For in November 45 he was forced to examine reports of the Irish potato famine. So Peel began to feel the need for repeal was real. The League was a mean propaganda machine, inspired by Bright and Cobden, with funds that were raised to finance a campaign which acquired a real political muscle. MPs in Parliament putting the argument so more out of doors would adopt them. Yet if Peel was convinced, since his party was not, he resigned, handing over to Russell. Still Peel inclined to feel the need for repeal was real. That the need for repeal was real, Sir Robert inclined to feel. But the Whigs were so split that to his consternation, Russell failed to form an administration. And so Peel returned to deal with the mathematics of repeal. The long, long list of protectionists headed by Bentinck and Disraeli argued not to depend on foreign corn, thus appending the view of Malthus's thesis. But as Irish distress led to crime and unrest, the situation was worsening daily, till with Whig and the Duke's support, repeal all went through, but with his party in pieces. For when Peel began to feel the need for repeal was real, that the need for repeal was real was how Peel began to feel. There were those in his party who called him traitor, but he believed the interests of the state were greater. Oh, once Peel began to feel the need for repeal of the corn laws was real. The need for repeal.